water. We then dip into our rooting solution, whether that be a gel or a powder, it doesn't matter. Make sure we got all sides covered. Put it in. We make sure there's no air. Air is not what is not good. We don't want any air pockets down there at all. So we just give it a little squeeze, just kind of pack it down, set it down. That's all good. Move on to our last two. And at the same time, remembering that these came from six separate seed females, okay, of Master Kush. So what I've done now is select one female, mother. Taking the clones off, all of them, only because I'm firing off a harvest right now. I want to get these ready so I can get my room off. So I'm doing these from a multitude, but this will be the one that I've selected in the end because it's short and it's bushy and it's what it's like for the mother. The rest of them will be flowered out with the rest of the room, and the other ones that I'm working on a bit of a breeding process for genetics, which is, again, better safe for a better session on genetics. So, in the end, we ended up selecting this one. The cloning process, the lower you can take the clones from, which is what I'm looking at now, the lower you can take them from, the better. Remember, we got to take our cuts on an angle, the sharp angle, make sure that we can hold it. I mean, you can grip it back like this. You got basically your stock. Dip it in some water. Make sure those air holes are plugged. We don't want air getting up into the stem. That is the one thing we don't want, or we'll end up with the failure rate or, a slow growth rate. And again, this is, as I said, out of these 24 here that I'm planting, I'm already expecting that I'm going to weed out two or three. They're indeed going to root, but they're either going to root late or they're going to root in a fashion that I'm not happy with. And for that reason, they'll be basically taken out. And I'll figure out which ones are the strongest, and I'll grow them from that point, and then I'll decide to what size do I want to grow them, keeping in mind that they double in size. So, with all that kept in mind, like these ones right now, I want to flower them quick because I have a restriction problem. And it's a height restriction problem. Oh, nice it is. That's where I forgot the dip. Good thing it's the last one. So dip in the water, go in, and back into here. So because of my height restriction problem, I have to get these in, because as soon as I trigger these into 12 and 12, they have been under 24 hours of light. Now some growers do 18.6, I choose to go 24 straight. I say to each their own. Even in this grow Bible here, the gentleman actually for years believed it was 18.6 and that it was a point of diminishing return. He's come to realize that that was wrong, and he's retracted that statement in this Bible. And that's just a note for those that may or may not choose to think there's a point of diminishing returns if you don't get a chance to plant a chance to rest. Marijuana doesn't need to rest. So when this is done, basically you put your top on, the top that you're going to need on here, your humidity bin, which I'm going to grab here, and again, because it's going to go in for right away, once it gets into my room, it'll be sprayed, your humidity bulb goes on. In my case, I have this here, my two tops that I will allow for air to either go in or to not go in. Now, once it's in here, what's important, what this does is allow the humidity to come up. By keeping the humidity up to 80%, that's what's important. If you're living in a cold climate, this time of year it's cold, it's December, you do want to put something warm under there. There's specialized heating blankets that are for this. There's specialized cloning units you can buy if you're a novice grower. And you can also stilt it, what I call stilting. And that's just simply raise this up on top of some sort of stilt, keeping it up in the air. As long as your room, if the temperature in your room is hot enough, you shouldn't have a problem with that. However, it is good to use a heating blanket. You've got that heating blanket under there, and there's a much faster way of success. And of course, again, spray them every day. Don't forget, once or twice every day is even better, because then you get that humidity up within the dome. And then the dome does its job, and you will be rooted. As soon as you see roots coming out, they're good for transplant, and you're good to go. And that's cloning 101 against Bill C26. Thank you very much, and have a good day.